king.
Should have used Energizer. They keep going and going and going and going.
I've been a fan for over 30 years. I know it was the king I saw.
I've been talking to him on the CB. The king, he's alive.
Oh, man.
I saw.
Yeah, it was him.
He was abducted by rock and roll loving aliens.
The spelling on the headstone indicates that, yes, the king is dead.
I'm not dead, baby. I'm just having a break. Have a break. Have a Kit Kat.
And I just got off the phone with the DNA specialist out of Arizona. He says he believes Eliza is Elvis's half-sister and that Elvis is still alive. He says the proof is there. DNA evidence doesn't lie. In the studio, Lauren Lee, Fox 13.
Time.
So they say it will rain a sunny day. I know, shining down like water. I wonder, have you ever seen the rain? someone, but it all works out. It doesn't matter much to me. Let me take you down, cause I'm going to Strawberry Fields. Nothing is real. Forever. No one I think is in my tree. I mean, it must be high or low. That is, you can't, you know, tune in, but it's alright. That is, I think it's not too bad. And I may take you down, cause I'm dream. I think a no will mean a yes, but it's all wrong. That is, I think I disagree. Let me take you down, cause I'm going to Strawberry Fields. Nothing is real. I'm should pass. But I know a love like ours will last and last. But maybe I was wrong to go and how I love should go.
Sometime in my life, I mean, I had a feeling that sooner or later somebody would find me alive. There are good reasons why I had to do what I did. I mean, America was under siege, man. Protests, drugs, hippies, violence. And I felt I could help America if I became a federal drug enforcement agent. I had read all the Captain Marvel Jr. comic books. I realized I looked just like him. I played a hero in all of my movies. Now, I wanted to be one in real life. I was going to be America's secret weapon to stop the America haters from destroying it. If I could help save America, maybe this was my real destiny that God had prepared me for all this time. I was an ordinary church-going country boy who just happened to love to sing rock and roll music. I didn't mean to put anybody through any pain. I never expected to be anybody important. I hope my story will inspire folks. You know, everyone can be a superhero for America.
For a moment, wasn't I?
You know, you were curious, sir, as to why I did what I did and you know, basically faked out, faked my death and everything back when I did what I did. And, you know, the most biggest reason, I guess, I would say is because of, if you don't know already, I was very deeply involved in the drug task force, and thanks to Mr. Nixon at the time, and I guess we had gotten very close to a drug lord that we were pretty much ready to bring down at the time. And I'm not going to elaborate on any of this because, you know, it's still a very touchy subject, but I have been in the witness protection program for many years, and anyway, we'll just leave it at that, you know.
Could you tell us where you went?
You're also curious as to
where I had gone and where I'd went and, you know, some of the questions, sir, that you've asked me, you know, do I still talk to Lisa Marie? Do I still frequent Graceland and where am I living? Actually, the answer to you know, the Lisa and the Graceland and things, the answer is yes. I do still talk to Lisa. I talk to my other daughter as well. You wanted to know if I had any other kids that children that I'm aware of. there was a fellow that I know that, you know, some information had come out a while back about a gentleman that goes by the name of Arian, and that I think is totally false. That I don't ever recollect of having a son, but I do have two girls, and we'll just leave it at that. As far as, you know, myself frequenting Graceland, and do I still go there? The answer to that is yes as well. I go there a lot during the holidays, and Lisa comes, you know, and visits me. And you know, sir, you're also wondering if I had gone under another name since I've, you know, been out of the public eye and gone into my personal quiet life, and the answer is yes. I've actually gone under the name John Burroughs, and that's Sos, and that's spelled J-O-N. I don't know how to spell it, you know, many different ways, but also you wanted to know if I was living with another woman. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, her name is Joanne, and we'll just leave it at that, sir. Wanted to know if I had any facial surgery, but the answer, actually I had a, you know, nose job, but that was back in the 60s, and most of the time, you know, it's just been a constant battle of growing beards and you know, wearing disguises and everything just to keep from being recognized the majority of the time, but being my age, you know, you gotta understand as well, sir, that it's actually a lot easier now that, you know, I mean, hey, I'm in my early 70s and things, I don't look like I used to, should I say. But anyway, as far as the why did I take the pills and everything, a lot of that was majority of, you know, was painkillers because of my back, and at the time a lot of it was just pressure from the guys in the band and you know, my bodyguards and everyone that I had worked with. And, you know, the drug thing was a big thing at the time, and of course, you know, we had plenty of access to it, and I know that what I did then, I regret to this day, that, you know, but I can honestly say that the fact of the matter is that I haven't even taken a sleeping pill in nearly 30 years, and I guess if I had the chance to do everything again, I certainly wouldn't, sir. So, you know, now as far as how I feel about my daughter Lisa marrying Michael Jackson, well, that, you know, I have no issues with that. You know, he's a very nice fellow at the time, and God rest his soul. I truly, truly do feel bad for you know, his family and everything. I know Lisa's been very upset about it, what have you, but that's pretty much all I can say about that. You know, I have no major issues pertaining to that whole ordeal. So, but anyway, I guess that's pretty much about all I have to say, sir. And, I can honestly say as well that, you know, I have left a lot of clues out there for people to know that I haven't gone. And, a lot of my songs have had clues in them, like My Way. My stone, Graceland, is totally spelled different, as pretty much everyone understands and notices. And there's a lot more things to come, but even though I'm older, I don't move around as fast as I used to, but I'm still here, and I want to let everyone know that, God willing, when the time comes, and I know I've had plenty of opportunities, but I'm going to make it known that it's been a long ride, and been very exciting.
I'm alive.
That's right. Thank you, baby. I love you too. I just bless every day, man.
When you call for me, when I hear you breathe, I get wings to fly. I feel that I'm alive. When you look at me, I can touch the sky. I know that I'm alive.
Everybody happy? Dance, baby.
When you bless the day, I just drift away. Oh, my worries die. I'm glad that I'm alive.
You set my heart on fire,
filled me with love, made me a man on clouds above. I couldn't get much higher, my spirit takes flight, 'cause I am alive. When you call on me, when I hear you breathe, I feel that I'm alive. I'm alive. That I'll be the one standing by through good and through trying times. And it's only begun, I can't wait for the rest of my life. When you call on me, when you reach for me, I feel
fantastic. Thank you.